out, it's Friday. Monday's a brand new start. Wednesday, you're halfway home. And Thursday, the weekend's not far. Saturday and Sunday, you hang with your friends. What can you say about Tuesday? Nothing, not a damn thing. Tuesday bites, Tuesday sucks, Tuesday blows, go away. Tuesday's crap, Tuesday's lame, Tuesday's dumb, go away. Tuesday. Saturday and Sunday, yeah. With your friends, what can you say about Tuesday? Nothing.
Gonna be another nice one, though. 72 and partly cloudy in our area, mostly sunny tomorrow with a high in the mid 70s, then looking up towards about 80 degrees on Thursday and Friday with no rain. No rain in the forecast.
No, Shaw, just steady warm up. That's all.
Shaw out again today on his little extended vacation weekend for his anniversary. So we'll hold down the fort this morning. Of course, if you need something, you can get in touch with us by visiting rockmornings.com. Check out the daily podcast and listen to the show live right there on the website.
I did drive through significant fog on my way to work this morning. Just be aware
expect
of that.
Expect that in your
area. Significant.
What's new on New Release Tuesday? We'll talk to Grant Bills from the Wisco Sports Show a bit later on. Are you feeling overwhelmed?
Always.
Okay. Give you a little help with that. A little tip you might want to try.
Okay.
What?
Nothing. It's going to be obvious and dumb and stuff that should work, but you just don't do because life.
I don't know. You might do this one. This
All
one's
right.
kind of,
all
this
right.
is in your wheelhouse.
Okay.
This,
right.
is, this has
I
got,
like it.
I saw this morning and I said, oh, this has got Jean written all over it. This is right in her alley.
All right. Bring it.
It feels, though, like... we'll get to it later.
All right.
We'll get to it later. Seether and Disturbed coming up in just a bit. Again, if you need something, visit rockmornings.com.
More of your Rock Mornings coming up in just a bit.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. 42 days, I think?
I think, yeah. Is there a ring? Is the chain ring thing where we take them
I told
apart?
You.
Let's do this.
I suggested that.
Yeah.
Shaw didn't even know what the hell that was. Former President Donald J. Trump scheduled to deliver remarks in Prairie du Chien on Saturday. According to an email from his campaign, the speech scheduled for about 11:30 at the Prairie du Chien Area Arts Center located on Crawford Street down there in PDC. Doors open at 8:30. Admission tickets, obviously, online. They're free. His campaign says the speech will focus on illegal immigration. I know there is also a bus tour or something like that.
Coming through the area.
It's going to be through the entire state of Wisconsin over the next couple of days. And this culminates apparently with him being down in Prairie du Chien on Saturday. Again, at 11:30 at the Arts Center down there.
Pretty drive right on the river there. Great River Road.
Kmart here in town closed several years ago. It's just been sitting there empty for almost, I don't know, 7-8 years now.
Long time.
Feels like forever. But the final full-size Kmart store in mainland USA is now closing.
The first one or like
the last one. They say full-size store. So I don't know. Do they have some kind of like little Kmart market or something that's inside of something else?
They like, might.
Kind of like Walmart's got a Subway in it. So Kmart is inside of a Subway. Is that?
No, maybe more
like. That
would
be a flip on the script, right?
Maybe more like a little gas station kind of thing in some areas.
The store is in Bridgehampton, New York on Long Island. It's due to close October 20th, according to an employee who answered the phone on at the store. So like somebody somebody from a news source called, be like, yeah, we heard you guys are closing. Is that true? He's like, I guess.
Yeah,
manager of the store not available, and corporate owner Transformco, the company that bought the remains of Sears and Kmart out of bankruptcy back in 2019, didn't return an email requesting comments. The chain still has a small convenience store version of itself in Miami, but not the full line of offerings that Kmart was once known for. So this final store out there in Bridgehampton, New York on Long Island is
closing
set to close
stores
in a couple of weeks. Kmart, blue plate special, right?
Mm-hmm.
Elsewhere, Defense Department plans to send a few dozen U.S. troops to the Middle East in the upcoming days to be ready to help Americans flee the region, bracing for a significant escalation in the simmering conflict between Israel and the Iranian-backed militant group Hezbollah in Lebanon. According to defense officials, U.S. forces will add to the roughly 40,000 troops already in the region. So they're there, they're ready, and it's mostly just to, you know, according to news reports, to prepare to get Americans out of that area if they're looking to flee.
Provide safety.
Pentagon Press Secretary Major General Pat Ryder said earlier this week that the U.S. was sending a small number of additional forces to, quote, augment our forces that are already in the region. He declined to identify how many of the individual troops would be deployed, why, or where, citing operational security. But, yeah, things obviously deadly in that region.
There must be another fishing tournament on the river this weekend. Is there something? I followed some big rigs. Or maybe they're headed out of town from the thing this weekend, but I followed a bunch of big rigs this morning.
I do know there's a conference in town here in La Crosse. There's some kind of business conference for people from around the state. I've seen a bunch of people walking around, and I heard about it yesterday, but they're only here for a couple of days because obviously Oktoberfest kicks off on Thursday, so they're like, we got to get out of there.
I saw three beer semis downtown filling up the bars this morning on my way to work.
Yep. Well, you're going to start to see the pool tables get moved out. You're going to start to see the spooky spin machines get taken away. You're going to start to see the beer deliveries and everybody getting ready.
What's happening this morning?
Plastic cups and all that stuff. Yeah, they're going to be transitioning to the Oktoberfest as they do every year. So,
for all intents and purposes, it looks like we have great weather throughout the state for the rest of the week. I mean, it looks like, you know, low 70s climbing up a little bit, but very scattered rain in the forecast. It shouldn't dampen anybody's spirits, and lots of sunshine throughout this week.
We were in Cleveland this summer. We stopped there to stay at the Christmas Story House, went to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, and we did not visit this brewery, but we did go to a couple. There's a brewery in Cleveland now that is banning children under 16 due to safety concerns and customer complaints. It's Forest City Brewery. They want beer drinkers, music lovers, sports fans, but no one under the age of 16. No kids allowed. He said this place, the owner of the place, says the place is equipped to be a beer garden, not necessarily a playground. The bar will be open to those 16 and over only due to safety concerns and customer complaints. You see it all the time. Mm-hmm. I don't know. We go to a ton of breweries. It happens everywhere. People bring in their kids. Not wrong, though. The kids, a brewery can be a fun place to run around, especially if it's an old mill building, you know, where a lot of craft breweries are.
And or there's the kids, an outdoor area.
And they're not really safe for kids to be running around in, and they can get into areas that can taint the product, you know, or cause a massive problem with brewing the beer, let alone injure themselves. Mm-hmm. So,
Do these guys have a full menu, too? Is this a restaurant also? Just,
I'm not sure, but it doesn't say anything on the story about food, but yeah. Forest City Brewery in Cleveland, banning kids. I will say, as an adult who does not have children, when you go anywhere, not just a brewery, and people have a ton of kids and they're screaming and yelling and running, it's like, bro, what are we doing here?
Well, that happens. That's called...
Keep your mistakes at home,
life.
Right?
That's
your problem.
Life.
Don't come out if you got your kids. We don't want to see them. We don't want to drink with them. I'm not here to drink with your kids. Yeah. Sports coming up in just a bit. Two Monday Night Football games last night. We'll talk about that. Also got some Disturbed after Seether with their latest.
Rock Mornings. On air. Online. On the app.
Disturbed with Indestructible. Some Seether before that. Their latest Judas Mind. It's Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Double dipping on a Monday night. Josh Allen and the Bills all over the Jaguars, 47-10, final score.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, what?
They throttled him.
Woo!
And the Bengals are now 0-3 on the season after they lost to Washington, 38-33. What is going on in Cincinnati? Traditionally slow starter, but something is wrong with the Bengals. 0-3. Not good.
Oof.
Week 4 will kick off on Thursday night with the Cowboys at the Giants, 7:15 on Amazon Prime. Bears will host the Rams on Sunday at noon. Packers at home against the Vikings on Sunday at noon. And the Lions will welcome in Seattle, undefeated Seattle, on Monday Night Football. Vikings, by the way, breathing a sigh of relief yesterday after they learned that their quarterback, Sam Darnold, and his left knee are not seriously injured. Tests reveal a bruise, but no structural damage. Darnold not expected to miss much, if any, time in preparation for this week's Week 4 matchup at the Packers. Yeah.
That's...
He's been balling out. Yeah. He's been playing well, and they can't afford to lose him.
Nope.
Chargers safety Derwin James has been suspended for a game without pay for repeatedly violating player safety rules.
Doing what?
Suspension came after James drilled Steelers tight end Pat Freiermuth in the head with his helmet while trying to make a tackle during their 20-10 loss to Pittsburgh on Sunday. That violation, the league said, is one of many that James has made recently.
Yeah, so he's a dirty player. Is that these are purposeful hits? These are just him playing hard and aggressive?
Yeah, so they gave him a game off without pay. Said, you're going to take a little break there. Brew Crew off yesterday. They're at Pittsburgh tonight at 5:40 for the first of three against the Pirates. Six games left in the regular season for the Brewers as they get ready for the postseason. We'll talk more about the Brewers and the Packers at 8:25 when Grant Bills from the Wisco Sports Show joins us. Always good to talk to him on Tuesdays at about 8:30.
He's going to be in town this week.
Yeah. Utah State accepting an invitation to join the Pac-12 and become the newly formatted conference's seventh member. Utah State's reported acceptance would make it the fifth school from the Mountain West to join Oregon State and Washington State in the rebuilding Pac-12. Utah State would join Boise State, Fresno State, San Diego State, and Colorado State, who have all announced they're going to join the league as well. Moving things around.
Yeah,
money. A lot of money to be made.
Yeah.
And in 28 years of the WNBA, no player has ever led the league in points, rebounds, and blocks in the same season until now. Asia Wilson did that in 2024 as the forward from the Aces totaled the league best 1,021 points, 451 rebounds, 98 blocks, and she's the MVP, MVP.
This is fire.
28-year-old winning her third MVP. This time around, it was unanimous. League made the announcement on Sunday. Congratulations to Asia Wilson, WNBA MVP. Sports on Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. We'll let you know what's new on New Release Tuesday in just a bit. Also get to some Blackstone Cherry. And if you want to get in touch with us, rockmornings.com. Be careful, the fog is.
I was just going to say, if you haven't left your house yet and you're not aware, it's very foggy throughout the valley this morning. So it could take you a little longer to get where you're going. Be careful.
Soupy.
There was pedestrians crossing the road. Could hardly see them in front of me.
Yeah. Lights on and slow down. Get where you're going safely.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Blackstone Cherry, their latest When the Pain Comes on Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Television tonight, you've got Dancing with the Stars over on ABC. It's Oscars night.
Ooh.
Oh, sounds riveting. Is there someone dancing that's got an ankle bracelet? Thought I saw that last week. Obviously, I don't pay very much attention to this crap, but I know people were up in arms on the internet.
Shouldn't be out.
Bad influence on kids, right? Mom, what's that thing on her ankle? Why does
Anna Delvey wearing an ankle bracelet?
Yeah, people are mad on the internet because one of the dancers is wearing an anklet. She's got a little bracelet there, a little some.
It's her tracking device.
Yeah,
stealing the show.
I'm on television. Why do I need to wear it when I'm on television? You can see me right here. You know where I am. Yep. I'm on television. Yep. Yeah. What is she wearing it for? What'd she get? DUI or something like that?
Defrauded friends and skipped out on bills.
Wow. White collar crime, huh? You get one of those for white collar crime?
You can. All right, white collar.
Well, she's got one. Apparently she bedazzled it or something.
Yes.
It,
yeah. She's technically under house arrest, but part of her release was an agreement that she wear this and...
She can dance on the stars.
She can dance on the stars, apparently.
Okay. Well, she's going to be dancing with her ankle bracelet. Nice piece of jewelry. Later on tonight on ABC on Oscars night.
White collar crime.
America's Got Talent recap special on NBC, followed by the 19th season finale of America's Got Talent. Also a new series premiere on Fox tonight called Murder in a Small Town. A New York City detective takes a job in a small town that isn't as quiet and peaceful as he expected.
Mystery lurking behind every door.
Over on Netflix today, the stand-up special Ellen DeGeneres, For Your Approval. This is like her swan song, right? She said, that's it, I'm going out.
Mm-hmm.
In a blaze of glory. She's not going to do any more celebrity stuff anymore because she's a mean boss.
And she's done.
Toxic
retiring.
Workplace environment. Late night television, Fallon's got Keith Urban and Margaret Qualley. Josh Gad is going to be on with Jimmy Kimmel. Kate Winslet talking to Stephen Colbert. Seth Meyers has got Will Ferrell and Harper Steele. Also, Kristen Bell on with Seth Meyers. Did you watch that? You said you wanted to watch that. The Will Ferrell?
It's the 27th, isn't it?
Oh,
I think
it's not
it doesn't
till the end of
Yeah, okay. I don't think it drops until
it's
Friday.
Like a road trip film with him and his friend from SNL who transitioned?
Yes. Okay. Lifelong friends and just how that, you know, is different. It becomes a part of his life and they drive across the country. I'm interested, but I don't think it's till the end of the week.
The clip where he tells her that she's a bad driver is hilarious. I died laughing at that one. New release Tuesday, Despicable Me 4.
That'll be a biggie.
Steve Carell, Will Ferrell, Sofia Vergara, Kristen Wiig, Stephen Colbert, ton of others.
Yeah.
Gru, Lucy.
Always funny.
Edith and Agnes. Welcome a new member to the family, Gru Jr., who is apparently intent on tormenting his dad. Gru has a new nemesis. Family forced to go on the run. Despicable Me 4. Minions, right?
Mm-hmm. We were at the Apple Orchard this weekend, and we couldn't remember Edith's name because it's kind of weird. You know, we were like, oh, there's Margot and Agnes, and what's the other one? And I had to look it up. I forgot it was Edith.
Also on DVD today for new release Tuesday, Bad Boys Ride or Die, rated R, Will Smith, Martin Lawrence, Vanessa Hudgens, Eric Dane, Tiffany Haddish, Joe Pantoliano. When their late police captain gets linked to drug cartels, Mike Lowry, Marcus Burnett embark on a dangerous mission to clear his name. I saw it.
Bad Boys, what? 8, 9,
Bad
10,
Boys,
12.
Ride or Die, 4. Fourth one. This one was good. We saw it in theaters. Long Legs, rated R.
This is already out.
Yeah. Micah Monroe, Nicolas Cage, Blair Underwood. People kind of compared it to Silence of the Lambs because it's a female FBI agent. It's kind of a creepy serial killer kind of guy. It's a bit more than that. It's different. It's got some parallels, but it was certainly creepy. There's a scene after Nicolas Cage gets arrested that's going to haunt you for a while.
Okay, no
it's
thanks.
It's haunting. In pursuit of a serial killer, an FBI agent uncovers a series of occult clues that she must solve to end his terrifying killing spree. Also on DVD for new release Tuesday, The Exorcism. This is rated R. Stars Russell Crowe, Ryan Simpkins, Sam Worthington, Chloe Bailey. A troubled actor begins to exhibit a disruptive behavior while shooting a horror film. His estranged daughter wonders if he's slipping back into his past addictions or if there's something more
sinister
at play.
I bet there's something more sinister at play.
Has nothing to do with The Exorcist or any of those Exorcist films. It's on its own. Also, In a Violent Nature, not rated. I would skip this. It had a lot of like buzz on the internet. It was not good. This is the one where it's shot from the behind the killer.
Uh-huh.
So a locket is removed from a collapsed fire tower in the woods, and then the entombed rotting corpse of Johnny, a vengeful spirit, is then brought to life, and he goes on a killing spree, and it was not good. There was a lot of buzz on that one on the internet. It's called In a Violent Nature. We couldn't wait to see it. We were excited, and it's boring. It's so boring. It's just, it's basically like a camera following this guy who's got a hood on his head and he walks around and he just walks. It's like him walking everywhere.
Does he?
And he kills a couple of people, like, which, you know, whatever, but it's just, there's nothing.
Walking and breathing.
It's just like, what are we doing? I spent an hour and a half watching this guy walk around the woods. Ugh. Also on DVD today for new release Tuesday, The Equalizer Season 4 and Young Sheldon Season 7. So there you go. That's what's on television and what's new on New Release Tuesday? A couple of minutes from now, give Gene a couple of tips on how to deal with being overwhelmed.
I'll take these tips.
You said you're overwhelmed all the time?
Well, I shouldn't say all the time, but it feels like it's extended periods of time right now.
All right. Well, maybe a little bit of help with that. We'll get to that after Buck Cherry.
Rock Mornings, only on 95.7 The Rock.
Buck Cherry with Crazy Bitch. On Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. But I won't do that.
I'll run right into hell and back.
That's what they say you should do to deal with being overwhelmed.
Love?
Don't do that. Write down things you don't want to do. It's perfect for you. Lists. Right up your alley.
Write down things I don't want to do.
Well, think of your list. It's always stuff I got to do.
Yes,
I got to do this. I got to do that. I got to do a million
for
things.
Sure.
What about the things you don't have to do?
You mean the things I don't want to do, but that I have to do? Because there's differences.
Won't do that. Don't do that. No, I won't do that. If you're feeling a bit overwhelmed, think about making a to-don't list as opposed to a to-do list.
Okay, tell me more about this to-don't list.
To-do lists. Everybody's got them. Whether you write them down, put them on a post-it note.
They're in your head.
In your head.
Taking up space.
That's how I take care of my business. Even though my brain's kind of a jumbled mix of feral cats from time to time. Keep that to-do list up there. Serves me well. But to-don't lists are for all the non-essential things we do that sucks up our time. Things we do in a certain way that might not be so hard if we changed them up.
What is non-essential? Tell me about this.
A to-don't list might include things like don't overcommit to social engagements. Don't offer to do favors for everyone. Don't schedule meetings before 11 a.m. And don't skip lunch just to keep working. It sounds like you got to do more work to come up with the don'ts.
If I don't have a meeting before 11, I'm here till 6. Get out of here with that one.
The idea behind the to-don't list is to be mindful about the stuff that's eating up your time and making life less enjoyable. But unlike to-do lists, you don't need to make every single one of those things happen every single day.
Mm-hmm. Well, I understand the concept, but
they say you should just do it once, then check on it to remind yourself of all the stuff you don't want to do.
Mm-hmm.
And to see if there's anything else you need to add to that list. Well, let's get started. What's something you want to put on your to-don't list for today?
My noon meeting. To-don't. That's not happening, though. Let's see. I don't really think I overbook socially to where I need to, like, eliminate some of those things. They're often commitments that I have to do, but it's not like I'm going here, going there with fun friend things that I need to slow down on. We've got, of course, Oktoberfest this weekend, so there's a lot of stuff, right? Thursday night, there's the craft beer event. We've got Stateroom, our broadcast on Friday. I've got a birthday celebration this weekend. Next weekend, we're volunteering at a cross-country regional meet.
You need to say no to things, I think, is where you put...
Gotta go see my mother.
...on your to-don't list. Remember to turn down engagements and social gatherings.
Volunteer opportunities for your kids' stuff? Yeah, sorry, we're not gonna do that. Hosting a team dinner for cross-country next week. Chilly, though. That'll be easy.
Yeah, I don't even know what the hell to do with you in a to-don't list, because... You don't say. You're like Jim Carrey in Yes Man. You ever see that movie?
Mm-mm.
Never seen that?
Mm-mm.
He basically has to say yes to everything. And he, like...
Can't say no?
Yeah. Takes guitar lessons, does all this crazy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
This is, like, old neighbor. Offers to give him some oral relief. And he takes her up on it because he's the Yes Man. No?
All right, well... Make your to-don't list. I do like the lunch thing.
Well, yeah, you eat. You just don't eat. You don't have lunch.
My desk, yeah.
Maybe that's something. Maybe that one small thing maybe you can do.
That's what I was thinking.
Like,
maybe
take the time to just say, look, I'm going to sit down. I'm going to eat a lunch like a human being, like a normal, regular-ass human being.
Even if it's one day a
and
week.
And not do anything for that 10 minutes.
That's
but
what I'm
eat.
Saying.
I'm not going to look at my computer. I'm not going to look at my phone.
Not going to talk to somebody. Not going to type an email. Or even better, I think I
like
could.
When you used to pump your boobs.
Right, I had to. Chill. I had to.
Right, but I'm just saying, you would close the door and you spend those 10, 20, whatever time it takes to.
Well, I could even
suck
take
the
it,
life out of those things and
take it up a notch. I could even try to pre-book a meeting every week on a certain day, so it says I'm busy, and then actually leave the building
for a little bit and go for a walk
and enjoy my lunch.
You used to do that. I remember you used to bring your lunch. You bring your shoes down here, and then you almost got assaulted.
Also true.
It was the lady after you.
On the bike path. I almost did, yes. So maybe I could I could have an outside the building once a week lunch. Maybe I'll start with that. I like that.
There you go. We just solved the world's problems right there. Bam. Check it out.
Look at us go.
Jean's got a to-don't list. Her to-don't list is don't eat lunch in the building while working.
Standing at
one
your desk.
Day a week. And getting interrupted 10,000 times by innocuous questions from stupid sales weasels.
Yay, me.
All right. It's a start. Lincoln Park in a couple of minutes. If you need something, visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings. Monday to Friday, 6 to 9.
Lincoln Park in the end. People are torn about this reunion / new version. Chester Bennington's son had some things to say about it. Some people on the internet are upset about it, think it's tarnishing Chester Bennington's legacy.
I think his son's opinions are important.
Oh, more than anybody, you mm-hmm. know. It feels like there is a rift there. Yeah.
Had they not talked about that with him before that was the thing that surprised me.
You would assume dude, the band that your, you know, dad became famous for being in.
Here's what our plans are moving forward. Yeah. You know? We're going to do this big step. We're going to announce a new singer. We're going to go out on tour. And here's that, you know, here.
Yeah, you feel like you'd want to have somebody that important in the fold when it comes to that stuff.
Unless they don't have a relationship with him.
Maybe they don't, you know. Ugh. Lincoln Park, in the end. Your kids have one teacher in particular that was impactful to them, that made a huge difference, that they look back fondly upon?
Thankfully, a number of them. Yeah, they've been blessed in the school district to have really great teachers, and many of them.
Oof.
But, yes, I think they all have one that they hold close to their heart.
I didn't help the situation any, go figure. But I don't remember any teachers growing up that I have a fondness for. I remember the bad ones, obviously. But, none that really stand out in terms of, like, made a huge impact on my life or made me feel special or whatever. I never had that. I did have one. Mr. Salvo was, like, a music teacher, and he was kind of unique.
Kind of got you in a little way?
Not just, like, at that time in my life, it was junior high school, and so I didn't really know where I was musically. You know, I had listened to a lot of stuff. I grew up, my parents listened to oldies or AM radio. I had listened to, you know, Red Sox games on the radio and whatever my parents were listening to in the car, but I didn't really know where I wanted to go musically. I had a friend who was into heavy metal, and so I started to kind of bleed that way. Donut was into R&B and hip-hop and rap and all that stuff and boy bands and whatever, so I just sort of... But Mr. Salvo, like, introduced me to a lot of, like, and I'm assuming other students, to a lot of different music. Like, mm-hmm. I found out about the Beatles and mm-hmm. a lot of classic rock and stuff through him, so. But I don't know if, like, I couldn't tell you anything other than that. I don't remember anything in terms of, like.
It's fun.
This teacher, though, is going viral. It's a guy, a fifth grade teacher, from Michigan, who is going viral because he eats lunch with his students in the lunchroom every day.
So I eat lunch in the cafeteria almost every single day, and here's why. So I teach fifth grade, and the 8 years of doing this, this is the most effective thing that I have to get to know my students on a personal level. And what happened when I walked into the cafeteria today and I sat down next to a couple of my new kids? Instantly, two or three more down the table were like, hey, can you eat lunch with me tomorrow? Because we can all agree that in this job, in education, in teaching, the single most important thing we can do is build a relationship with every single kid that walks in the door. We can't do our job without it.
Guy's name is Dan Schutz. He's a fifth grade teacher in Paw Paw, Michigan. Going viral on social media after he revealed that he eats lunch daily in the cafeteria with his students.
That's
rather
great.
Than in the lounge or in a separate room or at his desk. Goes and sits down, hangs out with the kids. It's got to be kind of weird. Stands out, right? None of the other teachers are doing that. And the other kids are talking to him. And tradition that he's been doing on a whim for a couple of years now. full-time teacher for 9 years. He said, it just turned into something that I really enjoy. The kids enjoy it. I enjoy it. The kids will ask me ahead of time, hey, can you sit with me tomorrow?
Mm-hmm. I can see how that's special for him. I can also see how he would want a break from the lunchroom and the loudness and the kids and the and goes to could go to the teacher's lounge, but chooses this instead. I know my kids always, there was teachers that would invite particular students to come eat lunch. Like, it was a special thing. It would rotate between kids, and there'd be two, three of them that would get to go eat with them in their classroom when no one else was there, and that was always a huge honor to be able to have lunch with the teacher, kind of in that more private setting. But I can see how this is really cool if he sits down next to you.
He said, I don't want to just be viewed as the talking head at the front of the room that is the guy giving them homework and assignments. Yeah. Well, that's obviously part of my job. I want to hopefully connect with somebody or a group of kids in a way that they can come to me with problems or concerns and are okay having conversations outside of the realm of the lesson plan. That's cool. Guy named Dan Schutz, fifth grader teacher in Paw Paw, Michigan.
Yeah, and I could see how a disenfranchised student or somebody who's more quiet or alone or doesn't have a lot of friends could really benefit from that teacher deciding to sit down next to you.
And well, and again, in a completely wildly different situation, right? In the classroom, boring, boring, guys talking, boring, boring, homework, assignments,
boring,
tired.
You see him more as a real person.
Right? I don't feel comfortable in the classroom. People are picking on me, whatever. But the lunchroom, right? Completely wildly different environment.
Mm-hmm.
You were asking me earlier, too. I was playing a video, and it was basically a woman moaning and screaming.
Screaming.
You'll find out why here in a minute. This is in northern Canada. What do you think of when you think of northern Canada?
Wildlife.
A lot of woods. Imagine you have a 6-year-old autistic daughter who goes missing in those woods for 3 days, and then you find her. You think you're going to make moaning sounds?
Ugh.
Think you're going to be crying and screaming and going crazy? Yeah. Child's been missing. Well, this was last week, but last Thursday, northern British Columbia found safe September 19th in the community of South Bank, about 25 kilometers south of Burns Lake and 200 kilometers west of Prince George.
So she
video
wandered.
Showing dozens and dozens of volunteers, searchers going through the woods, dense forest.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And then cheering, as you heard at the end, as the child is reunited with her mother, taken into an ambulance. Girl located on Sunday, again, 3 days after she went missing in a forested area near her home. Officials apparently had searched the area earlier. They believe she was likely moving around during the time that she went missing, rather than just staying in one place. But obviously the mom, very emotional.
6-year-old,
yeah, 6-year-old Oakland Schweder found in the forested area between her home and the local Indian band office. Sergeant of the police department there said the outcome that we all hope for. Yeah, and video of it going viral now is her mom Gail, along with others, rushing into the forest after they found her and carrying her out. And oof, can't even imagine. Get to Stained and Alice in Chains in a couple of minutes. And if you want to get in touch with us, visit rockmornings.com.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Folks, are you struggling with how to raise your bundle of joy? Boy, grab a pencil and listen up. From the groundbreaking book of 1926, we've got modern baby advice you don't want to miss. First, be sure to dip your baby in cold water each morning. It's invigorating. Second, don't spoil them with too much affection. A firm handshake will suffice. And remember, if a baby cries, simply feed them on a strict schedule, even if they're screaming for more. It's the bee's knees of baby rearing advice, so get with the times.
Somebody found a book that's 100 years old.
And it says terrible things about taking care of babies.
Yeah, this is like those, you know, guides for women back in like the 50s and 60s on how to, you know, how to show your husband affection, you know, all these things that are old and, you know, way past their prime. But the book, How to Raise a Baby, from 100 years ago, 1926.
Okay, how do you raise a baby?
These are just some of the excerpts from the book, right? Some of the more ones that are a little more outlandish that maybe don't make as much sense.
Yeah.
That didn't stand the test of time, but here we go. Okay. BuzzFeed, by the way, .com has the entire list if you want to check it out. Some mothers, in an attempt to soothe the child, allow thumb sucking or the use of pacifiers. This is most objectionable. Constant thumb sucking often causes deformity of the mouth and jaw and crooked teeth.
It does.
But it also shuts that baby up.
It's human nature. It's hard for them not to soothe themselves with something. That's why pacifiers were created, so it didn't do as much damage to the...
Pacifiers recommended to reduce the risk of SIDS. While thumb sucking can cause tooth problems, the American Academy of Pediatrics says it's not a concern unless the habit persists past 5 years old.
Yes.
When the teeth really start to come in. Not to mention, you're going to lose that first set anyway. So.
I had three. That's why I had three sets of braces. Invisalign's braces, jaw spreaders, the whole thing.
It is now considered advisable to give cod liver oil, a preventative of rickets, in proper amount to all infants before the end of the first month, preferably by the end of the second week.
That must have been enjoyable for those infants. Whatever.
Even an ad that says, milk, of course, but don't forget cod liver oil and orange juice.
Yeah.
Cod liver oil, by the way, no longer recommended for infants under 1 year of age.
But probably didn't do any damage to him. It just was terrible.
Yeah.
Didn't have any benefits, didn't do any damage.
Well, it was one of those things that, you know, some guy in a, you know, some gypsy came through town selling snake oil, and they're like, all right, well, we'll try it. Right? Rules for the mother preceding birth. This one doesn't sound too bad. She should not attend plays, read books, or frequent company which may destroy the peace of her mind or get her in an overexcited condition.
Okay, all right.
What's wrong with getting a little rest? Not
she
being overexcited.
Read or go to plays because she might not be able to handle that baby. You know, there are people who now run marathons while they're pregnant.
Well, there's also nothing wrong with taking a nap.
A play. Oh, I can't handle it.
Well, you get overexcited.
The actors. Oh, my.
You also have to think about what kind of clothes they were wearing back then. You know what I mean? They're like stuffing each other in these dresses and tying them up in the back. And
if I read this book, I'll get overstimulated. And
this one's
it'll
good.
Be bad for the baby.
Again, a baby book. Somebody found a baby book, How to Raise a Baby, from 1926. And these are just some excerpts from the book on how to better raise your child from 100 years ago. The most satisfactory bed is of enameled iron or brass. It is easily kept. The side should be lined, especially for a newborn baby.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, nice metal crib for the kid. It's real safe.
Probably pretty. And
they also say cribs should not be lined. Crib bumpers have been outlawed in the U.S. because of the strangulation and suffocation risks they pose.
But that was 100 years ago. It was better than that.
Didn't have a lot of plastic
dresser
available.
Dresser drawer. Just shove you in a dresser drawer.
What's wrong with
a
dresser drawer?
There's nothing wrong. My brother was in a dresser drawer.
Here you go, Gene. Again, a book of how to raise a baby from 1926. Mother and child are both exhausted after the birth, and both require a long, restful, unmolested sleep. Usually, for the first 12 to 24 hours, the newborn infant sleeps peacefully and continuously. And on no account should it be aroused, not even to be displayed by a proud parent to an expectant group of relatives.
Probably has to try to eat in there somewhere. And
babies usually sleep after their first feed. That could be up to 6 hours. But yeah, probably going to be some feeding. And obviously, if there's some kind of medical situation, might not be. This one's good. This is something you could probably relate to. The most satisfactory and safest treatment for constipation over any length of time is afforded by injections of hot water or chamomile tea. Glycerin and soap enemas, when continued, are irritating to the bowel.
Yeah, I bet.
One should always await 2 days before resorting to an enema. The injection should be given with a bulb syringe, which holds about 2 ounces. You shooting your baby up?
With tea?
Hot water or chamomile tea? Or giving them a soap enema?
Yeah, oof.
That sounds fun. According to the Mayo Clinic, don't use mineral oil, stimulant, laxatives, or enemas
don't
to treat infant constipation.
Nope.
There's a whole bunch of other ones in there, but yeah. Just a couple of the very strange suggestions from How to Raise the Baby.
Made sense at the
a
time,
book somebody
I'm sure.
found from 1926. Davey texted in and said, we used to give my oldest cod liver oil with orange juice, and it was awful. But I will tell you, as he got older, there isn't almost anything he won't eat. The least picky kid I've ever met in my life when it comes to food.
Because he got tormented? Is that what happens? He remembers that?
Yeah, I don't know if you can draw. I mean, you can certainly, you know, say in your minds that all
those
that
two things correlate.
That cod liver must have made him open and available to any kind of food. But maybe he's just one of those kids that eats, you know, whatever. I mean, cod liver oil. Yeah. No thanks. Sports coming up in a bit. Alice in Chains after Stained. It's Better Days.
Rock Mornings on 95.7 The Rock.
It's like a DVD. A VR. DVR. I don't know. That's it.
This little DVD thing that used to put in the VCR?
A VHS, right?
Yep.
CD. This is like just a regular CD.
CD?
I don't know. IBM?
Oh, floppy disk. Is that what it is? Is that a floppy disk?
Dang, I would have never gotten that.
Y'all got me on this. I don't know this.
Yeah, this thing we used to put in the music thing, play like tones and stuff like that.
Yep.
I don't know what it's called. A lot.
This is the cassette, right? Times has changed.
Ugh, I love this.
Tampa Bay Buccaneers having some fun with a couple of their rookies, asking them to identify items from the 90s, including a VHS tape, a floppy disk, and a cassette tape.
Feels like the VHS was the one that gave them the most difficulty. They seem to get the rest of them relatively quickly.
NFL rookies, probably early 20s, so born late 90s, early 2000s.
I have no idea what that is that you're holding. Maybe my grandparents owned it.
Week 3 in the NFL wrapped up last night with the Bills all over the Jaguars, 47-10. Bengals are now 0-3 on the season after they lost to Washington, 38-33. Week 4 will kick off Thursday night with the Cowboys at the Giants. That game on Prime at 7:15. Packers host the Vikings on Sunday at noon. Mm-hmm. Vikings should be okay with Sam Darnold. Sounds like he just bruised that knee as opposed to any serious structural damage. I'm talking on the radio, dude. Yeah. I can't help you. I'm talking. Go over
know.
There.
He doesn't know.
Jesus Christ. Hey. Sorry. Brewers off yesterday. Pittsburgh tonight, 5:40, the first of three against the Pirates.
They were kind of on a, they had a rough weekend, so this
Yeah, they lost 3 out of 4 to the Diamondbacks and trying to get right.
Come back with confidence here.
Speaking of trying to get right, this is awful.
What?
5 Tufts University lacrosse players are still hospitalized days after a dozen athletes were injured following a workout led by a Tufts and Navy SEAL training program alumnus. So the guy went to Tufts, is a former Navy SEAL.
Mm-hmm. Graduate of the program, came back to...
Came back and then wanted to do some kind of hardcore Navy SEAL workout, and a bunch of people ended up getting hospitalized. Patrick Collins, a spokesperson for the university, said 12 members of the men's lacrosse team diagnosed with rhabdomyolysis, or rhabdo, for short, which is a life-threatening condition after a workout on Monday of last week.
12 of them?
Collins said 50 people participated in the 45-minute workout on campus on Monday, which was led by an alumnus who is a recent graduate of the Navy SEAL training program. Collins called the workout voluntary and supervised. The Navy SEAL, the BUD, the BUDS Navy SEAL program, short for Basic Underwater Demolition and SEAL, is a 56-week multi-stage initial training program for Navy SEAL candidates. 56-week, Jesus Christ. That's a long-ass training.
It sure is.
According to the Navy, the training is designed to push you to your physical and mental limits, according to the website. And apparently there was some kind of 45-minute abridged version of this thing going on. And a bunch of people ended up in the hospital.
Ugh. Yeah, not like just one or two guys. I mean, that's 12 people.
Crazy.
from a lacrosse team who are fit. It's very physical and lots of running.
Last but not least. No chance. That's what you got. Former WWE CEO Vince McMahon slamming the upcoming Netflix docuseries called Mr. McMahon, saying it's misleading and deceptive. The founder of the WWE said in a statement yesterday that he didn't regret participating in the Netflix documentary, which will be released later this week. 6-part series chronicling his rise to power and the controversies that surrounded him. A trailer for the series hints that the lawsuit brought on by a former WWE employee accusing McMahon of sexual abuse and assault and human trafficking. McMahon said the producers had the chance to, quote, tell an objective story about my life and the incredible business I built, which were equally filled with excitement, drama, fun, and a fair amount of controversy and life lessons. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, based on an early partial cut I've seen, this doc falls short and takes the predictable path of conflating the Mr. McMahon character with my true self, Vince. The title and promos alone make that evident. So, yeah, he's not on board with it as of yet. But he's only seen a partial cut, apparently.
Well, it paints him in a very bad light, it sounds like.
Well,
that isn't like just a little bit. That's like that's a lot.
There's a lot of bad stuff that happened. So I don't know what you expected the outcome to be on that one there, Mr. McMahon, but that'll pop up on Netflix later this week. Sports on Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. We got Hailstorm and I Prevail. And some Metallica coming up in just a bit. Rockmornings.com if you want to get in touch with us.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
Hailstorm and I Prevail. Can you see me in the dark? You got a clean Google?
Yep.
You ready?
Yep.
This is house porn.
Ugh, I don't know if I want to see it. Is it like the best?
You're going to love it. Trust
me. I am going to love it. Because I just saw a magazine this weekend that was like, the 40 best kitchens in America or something. I was like, ugh.
It's nice because you'll never be able to afford it. Oh. So there's no real, like, dream here. It's just awesome.
Because I opened it up to page 3 and there was my roll-away dishwasher on the best kitchens of America.
215.
Like 215?
215 space UNCAS, UNCAS. Point That's Road.
Should Guilford, pop right up. Connecticut? Is that?
Yes. It's got.
Is this the. Okay. Is this
three docks,
Zillow?
Boat lift, vineyard, orchards, tennis and basketball court, go kart track, Stonehenge, fruit trees. Wait. It's got a Stonehenge?
Are you telling me that this is it? This is scenery? Have you ever been to Stonehenge?
Like a life-size replica of Stonehenge in the backyard of this thing.
I see it. The circle.
Look at that go-kart track. First thing, bam, go-kart track. All up in your grill. It's got its own vineyard. Look at the vineyard.
I see.
Oh, my God.
Well, look at the cove that it's on with the water.
The only problem with this is it's in Connecticut. It's like in the wintertime. It's like, I don't want to be there. It's going to be suck.
It's not the only problem. It's also $35 million.
6 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms, 5,354 square feet, 215 Uncas Point Road in Guilford, Connecticut. By the way, according to Zillow, the monthly payment is a very low and reasonable $247,000 a month.
A month?
For this $35 million home.
Oh, my gosh.
Built in 2009. Single-family residence. It's waterfront, FYI, in case you're wondering.
Oh, very waterfront.
Yeah.
Wow.
Three docks, boat lift, vineyard, orchards, beautiful gardens, fruit trees, tennis and basketball court, go-kart track, 2 houses and a carriage house. The main house, a testament to exceptional craftsmanship, showcases approximately 5,500 square feet of living space with 6 well-appointed bedrooms. And 4.1 bathrooms. Designed with the finest materials. Oh, my God. This home seamlessly blends timeless elegance and modern conveniences, providing a harmonious living environment. Outdoor area includes a pool, a spa, outdoor kitchen, guest house.
I see that.
The guest house is bigger than my house and your house If they had sex and produced twins.
It would be bigger than that. Also, that outdoor
3,500 square feet for the guest house that includes three bedrooms and three baths. A separate 942 square foot one bedroom in-law staff quarters in the guest house.
Mm-hmm. So last year, that's property taxes.
What I love about this is that in the description, there's no mention of Stonehenge, which they call the circle of life.
I see that.
Out in their backyard. They've got a Stonehenge.
There. Are you telling me that this is it? This is scenery?
It's a...
Have you ever been to Stonehenge?
It's a circle of life right there. The taxes?
Yeah.
Were $72,000 last year. The taxes.
Man. $35 million home in Connecticut.
I don't get people. I don't
go-kart
get
track. You'd think for the money, you could get a better-looking go-kart track. I mean, it's cool that you got one, but it's flat. With round, like, it's got turns and stuff, but there's no up, down, no tunnel, no bridge, no nothing. No water. Like, you don't drive over any water. There's no stream or brook or anything.
It's just around.
Come on, man. What kind of cheap-ass people are you? Your cheap-ass go-kart track?
You could make
boo,
it more.
Boo! Boo!
More beautiful.
Sorry, but the go-kart track's not speaking to me. Mm-hmm. I could afford it. I like the pool, the spa, the circle of life, the vineyards, all that stuff. But this go-kart track sucks. Who designed this thing? Some 80-year-old man?
It just goes around and around.
It stinks. Might be the worst-looking go-kart track I've ever seen. Bro, we want to go uphill. We want to go downhill. We want to go through a tunnel. Something. You paid $35 million for this house. This is all I got. This crappy ass go-kart track.
One tree around it or
nothing. I got nothing.
One little bridge.
Give me a break. If you want to check it out, it's 215 Uncas Road, a Point Road in Guilford, Connecticut. $35 million home. A little home porn for you on Zillow. For sale, Gene.
Yeah, I see.
I don't even care about all the other crap. That go-kart track really has made me angry.
Now you're angry about that?
I didn't even think about it at first. I'm like, oh, cool, go-kart track. But then as I got a good look at it, I'm like, this is like the least fun go-kart track of all time. Who the hell wants to go out there and do that? There's no danger. There's no threat of getting
around
injured.
Around and around and around.
You're just going around in circles.
Mm-hmm.
All right, you got a couple of turns. Whoop-de-doo. You don't have a bank, like an embankment, like a NASCAR track where you go up on the wall?
Over the water, underneath a tunnel, back up the other side.
I get it. You probably can't dig down too deep, right? Because you got, you know.
Because you're right on the water. Right?
But you could put a hill in or something, man.
Ugh. Never mind. I don't want it.
Yeah, I'm out. Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to have to do something about this go-kart track.
Plus Connecticut. Meh.
I think they're trying to encourage you to buy all the properties, too. Or are they all included?
They're all included.
Like the three different properties inside the line there?
Mm-hmm.
The 175 and the 44?
It's
and
all in the 135 million.
So those must be the guest houses, then.
Yes.
Oh, my God. Wow, and then you get to look at photo 3. Like, it's beautiful, but, like, look at all the boats that are inside that little bay.
I see that.
That's a lot of traffic, bro. For $35 million, I don't want nothing to do with any of these people. I don't want them in my private bay.
I don't think it's your private bay.
Well, it should be for that kind of price. It doesn't mention anything about home defense systems, rocket launchers, or nothing. It does have a nice little gazebo out there.
It has a lot of nice stuff in that orchard
there.
It has a lot of nice stuff.
The one thing that's not nice is that go-kart track. That thing stinks.
Why don't we set up a booking and take a tour and tell them that?
Does it come with all the furniture?
No.
That kitchen's nice, though, with that little bar in the middle. Oh, yeah.
I could do without the red stove.
Yeah, the red is a weird touch, but...
Mm-hmm.
215 Uncas Point Road in Guilford, Connecticut, if you want to give it a look on Zillow. Mm-hmm. It's a hell of a property, but that go-kart track stinks. Not a fan. We'll get to Grant Bills at about 8:25. Join us from the Wisco Sports Show. Bad News, Happy Music a bit later on. Also, daily check-ins. Find us online at rockmornings.com if you want to get in touch with us. Here's Metallica.
Rock Mornings on your rock station.
Metallica, Until It Sleeps. fifth member pre-sale yesterday. Didn't have any luck.
How'd that go for you?
Well, so Legacy Club was at 10 a.m. Fifth Club member pre-sale was at noon.
That's you.
And that was me. So I was ready at home. Wife came home for lunch. We were both on our computers. She was on her phone. We got into the queue, got ready to buy
the
tickets.
Exciting. How long were you in the queue?
A couple minutes. It didn't start until about quarter to noon. So we were in the queue for a few minutes, and then we got the tickets on the screen. The problem was is we had a specific enhanced experience we were looking for, and when the tickets became available and we were in the, you know,
able to purchase,
there were none available. So I don't know if they sold out that quickly or if they didn't make any available yesterday. So there's another presale today that starts at 10 a.m. It's a Citibank card presale.
This is for the whole tour all at once?
I don't know. I have no idea. I only care about the show that I'm going to, but I think they all go on sale today. And they go through SeatGeek for some of these because some NFL stadiums use SeatGeek instead of Ticketmaster. So the one in Nashville that we're going to using SeatGeek, which I got to be honest, was not bad compared to some of the troubles people have with Ticketmaster. We didn't seem to have any troubles with them. The only trouble I had was my mouse kept freezing up on me. And of course, I'm like, worst time ever, you know, freaking out, slamming the mouse down, trying to put new batteries in the damn thing. So hopefully today, fingers crossed, at 10 a.m. when the Citibank presale happens for the Metallica show in Nashville, the two-night 2025, I think it's May 1st and 3rd, we'll be able to get the package that we want to get. If we can't, then we're probably going to just opt for floor seats. But yeah, we were kind of bummed, but we'll see what happens today.
So this reviewer had the pleasure of being inside the snake pit. Is this what you're speaking of?
Yeah, so there's a couple different versions. The snake pit one, I think it's like $800 or $900 per person. It includes, you know, you get into the snake pit. I think there's a Yeti cooler or thing you get. I'm not quite sure.
Pleasure of being inside the snake pit for two Metallica shows. How was it, and was it worth the money, and would I do it again? My takeaway is that everything Metallica control was amazing. Their show was incredible. From that standpoint alone, it was worth every penny. On the other hand, there were a few things I wish I had known ahead of time.
Everything like such as?
Everything like such as.
I don't think you can drink in there because some of the packages offer you free drinks at the venue.
And this was not.
But they don't mention that in the snake pit experience, so my guess is they don't let people bring drinks in there. You can leave the snake pit and go get a beverage if you want, but you can't. I don't think you can bring it in. They don't explicitly state that, at least nothing that I saw.
Okay. How? Priority merch stand access, apparently. That's not really
I'm not surprised. Well, we're going to be there for the entire, like, 4 or 5 days, and they usually do pop-up stores, which is where you can kind of avoid the lines because they have them up for days in advance as opposed to trying to get merch at the show when there's a bazillion people waiting in line to get t-shirts.
Apparently there's a pre-show black box lounge that's pretty cool, I guess. That's like draped off and there's some memorabilia instruments and then some food and catering in there. That part's a thumbs up and part of the snake pit thing. So
we'll see what happens. Hopefully at 10 a.m. today we'll get lucky. Grant Bill's going to join us in about a half hour. We've got some Finger 11 coming up next.
More of your rock mornings coming up in just a bit.
Finger 11 with Paralyzer on Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene.
Still foggy. It should eventually lift, and a sunshiny day. I mean, decent, low 70s and warmer as the week goes on with not really a threat of rain, but very foggy this morning.
Stephanie McMahon. I'm never going to be done. Vince's daughter. Former WWE wrestler who married Triple H. 48 years old today. Steph, 48.
She's well-liked, isn't she, or not?
Probably more than her dad at this point.
That wouldn't be hard.
She's 48. Sean Crayon, 55, the clown in Slipknot.
Was Knot Fest just this past weekend?
Yeah. I saw Benji's video. It didn't look fun.
Well, that was of the
merch line. It just looked like a bank line without the
dividers.
It just
dividers. Kept going and going and just, going and going and going.
And then they had to cut it short because of weather. And so, bummer. Phil Hartman, born on this day in 1948, died in 1998.
Rocket fuel malt liquor. Damn.
Your favorite?
My favorite. He's hilarious.
Phil Hartman, born on this day in 1948.
Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I'm just a caveman. I fell in some ice and later got thawed out by some of your scientists. Your world frightens and confuses me.
This is so funny. Phil Hartman, born on this day in 1948. Also born on this day, way back in 1936, Jim Henson, creator of the Muppets, died in 1990. Jim Henson's birthday today, 1936. On the Muppet Show tonight. Brum, brum, brum. Who's your favorite Muppet?
I really like Animal.
My wife loves the prawn. Pepe the shrimp, Gonzo's buddy, Pepe.
Yeah.
Loves him. Laughs every time
Swedish
he's on the screen.
Chef cannot not laugh. Yep.
Yeah. There's some good ones in there.
But then you gotta love all the sweet Kermit, ones with Kermit Ozzie, and the Gonzo.
September 24th, 235 years ago today, 1789, the very first Supreme Court established. Six justices nominated by George Washington. It wasn't until 1869 that Congress set the number of justices to the nine that we still have today.
Justices.
47 years ago today, 1977, The Love Boats made its debut on ABC. We've been waiting for you, love. You know Lou Rawls was tipping them back on Baywatch nights. I think about that every time I hear the Love Boat song. I don't know why. 1982, Amityville 2, The Possession in theaters. That was the one with Paulie from the Rocky films as the dad. And the son and daughter were ancestral. Hell yeah. Amityville 2, The Possession.
Yeah.
No?
Sounds like they need some therapy.
Need something. 33 years ago today, 1991, Dr. Seuss died of cancer at the age of 87. His real name, Theodore Seuss Geisel.
Tomorrow is Christmas. It's practically here.
Never had any kids of his own. His first book rejected by over 20 different publishers. On this day, September 24th, 1991, two legendary albums in the world of rock and roll and music in general made their way into stores on the very same day.
Tell me about them.
Red Hot Chili Peppers releasing their fifth album, Blood, Sugar, Sex, Magic.
Yep, it's a biggie.
Featuring Under the Bridge, Give It Away, Suck My Kiss, and so many others. Those chilies out. Red Hot Day.
Oh. Just saw a video this past weekend of a little tiny girl who was eating cereal with a doll arm as her spoon. She had taken it off her doll, Amy. Her mom was like, "What is that, Amy's arm?" And she's like, yeah, it is. And she's in the corner with the doll eating the cereal, but she's itty bitty wearing a Red Hot Chili Peppers t-shirt.
Red Hot Chili Peppers releasing their fifth album on this day in 1991, Blood Sugar Sex Magic. Meanwhile, Nirvana also released an album called Nevermind that featured all the hits. Mm-hmm. Smells Like Teen Spirit, Come As You Are, Lithium, In Bloom, and yeah. Pretty big day in music. Two essential albums in stores on the very same day. 1993. How many years ago is that?
Math.
31 years ago today.
What happened?
31. This effing movie is 31 years old.
All right.
Dazed and Confused. In theaters on this day in 93.
Yeah. Grown up. Got a mortgage.
Be a lot cooler if you did. And in 2007, The Big Bang Theory made its premiere on CBS, ran for 12 seasons. I never got into it, man.
No.
Big Bang Theory, no?
No, not me either. But I know a lot of people that are.
Oh, yeah. Now it's, Young Sheldon, right?
Uh-huh.
There you go. Some birthdays and some stuff that happened on September 24th. Going to get to Grant Bills here in just a bit. Also got some music on the way from Foo Fighters, so stick around.
Rock Mornings. On air, online, on the app.
Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene. Got a text from Smokin' Joe, guy in Wyoming.
Wyoming. What'd he say?
Says, good morning, Rock. I just turned a lady friend onto your morning show, so be nice. I said, you got a new girlfriend? And he said, yes, I do, and this one is not crazy. Give it time, Smokin' Joe. Give it time.
Well, I'm glad that you've...
Welcome aboard, whatever your name is, young lady.
I'm glad you're listening.
Sounds like Smokin' Joe's going through it out there in Wyoming. Brenda texted in, wants to hear some Judas Priest. They're in Rochester, Minnesota tonight. I asked if she's going, and she said, yes, we are. And wondered if we were going, and I said no.
At the Mayo Civic Center, I believe, is that show tonight. That's a busy week. There's a lot. There's Megadeth at the
Armory. Megadeth's up in the Armory with all the remains of Mudvayne. Yeah, so I don't go to shows on school nights anymore. I can't do it. Can't get it done.
Well, especially ones that are out of town where you have to add another hour or hour and a half to get home.
Yeah, and don't get me wrong, Rochester's short, you know, short drive, so but still, like, you know, show gets over at 11. I get up and come to work at 1, so.
If it wasn't Fest Week, too. Oktoberfest Week is a busy one. Craft beer night, are you looking forward to that?
Oh, yeah. Also got a text from Tom. Says they need to build a Mario Kart track.
Yeah, it's
at that house
basic.
In Connecticut. He
it's
said,
pretty basic.
He said the go-kart track in the movie Heavyweights was better than that one. Yeah.
I mean, if we're drudging rich people on rich people's stuff, it's pretty...
It just, for the amount of money and the investment you make in that house, $35 million, mm-hmm. all the stuff that you got going on there, orchards and vineyards and
Stonehenge.
And that's the... That's the go-kart track you're going to put out on the on
that's
on
right
a plate?
Out front, too, like right by the front of the house and by the pier. And
I mean, I like the idea of having a go-kart track, but again, you invested $35 million in that place. What that's the best you can do? Mm-hmm. Not one hill?
Mm-hmm.
Nothing? Not one obstacle? Nothing? Come on, brah. No banking? Mm-hmm. You don't got go-karts to go fast enough for some banking? What are we even doing here? You might as well put a train on a track. You know what I mean? One of those stupid...
Just goes around and around.
Just
round
in a little circle, a little carousel.
With the little ones that ride the cars, the little tiny...
Now, if you're a baller and you do it Silver Spoon style and it's in the house, okay, all right. That was kind of neat. But come on, bro. If you're going to flex your wealth, put a better go-kart track up. Seriously.
They probably have regrets.
No regrets.
Mm-hmm.
Not even one letter? Grant Bills coming up in just a couple of minutes, but first, some Foo Fighters. Best of you.
Rock Mornings with Brian, Gene, and Shaw.
That is the Foo Fighters and Best of You. Joining us on the phone at about 8:25 on Tuesday mornings, the host of the Wisco Sports Show, heard nationwide.
I don't think it's...
If you're listening online.
Yeah, that's true. On the app or online.
Worldwide leader in sports.
Space.
Can we say that?
Listening in space.
Listening on the space station where you're stuck until February. Grant Bills, how are you, sir?
I am well. When you say Tuesday morning at 8:25, the way that you said it, it almost sounded like a passive-aggressive reminder, like I need it. Like, I don't look forward to this conversation all day Monday, and it's not the first thing I think about when I wake up.
No, it's... Grant, listen. You've worked in radio long enough to understand branding. We're branding you.
Okay, you're reminding people.
You're becoming a regular appearance on our program, 8:25 every Tuesday, just like Doc on Fridays. You know, when we do racing, we've done him for years. Bad News with Happy Music is always at the same time. I mean, we just, you know, you try to keep people's schedules so they're in tune. They know when things are happening. You can't just go all willy-nilly.
Good. Well, the your tone and delivery made it seem like a passive-aggressive reminder to me, so I just want everyone to know that. That was not the case. Good. I love reminding folks. I look forward to this every week.
I think you would think I sound like that no matter what I say.
That's true. It's aggressive or passive aggressive, one of the two, but it's always one.
All right, let's get the sports crap out of the way so we can get to the real good stuff here. Brewers lost 3 out of 4 to the Diamondbacks over the weekend, had a big 8-run comeback on Sunday. They've got 6 more games left. Are they completely out of contention for the number one spot in the NL?
Pretty near, yeah. The door is open, like if the Dodgers or one of those teams were to collapse, but I basically stopped paying attention to that. I think losing 3 out of 4, almost losing 4 out of 4, they should have got swept by the Diamondbacks. Losing those 3 or 4 games basically put the final nail in the coffin.
Okay.
The fact that it was even a possibility into the last week of the season, I think that accomplishes the goal of keeping them locked in as much as possible, right? Whereas if you have 2 weeks left in the season and nothing to play for, maybe you start to fall asleep. Then again, they look pretty sleepy against the Diamondbacks. So maybe, I don't know, maybe all in the end, maybe it means nothing and the playoffs is a new season. And once the playoffs starts, anything can happen. So I don't know what to think anymore.
What, I didn't even look, so I don't know. But wild card happens, I'm assuming, this weekend. And then next week we get started with the first round?
The final game of the Brewers season is on Sunday. So I'm going to the game Saturday night. I think the wild card games, I haven't seen a schedule yet. I would imagine, like, I don't know, Wednesday of next week, maybe Tuesday of next week. Probably a lot of those games will be during the day. I would bet that the Brewers, the wild card games would be during the day.
Yeah, usually they have them like early afternoon, late afternoon, and then after that we get primetime games.
Yeah. Yep.
All right.
And it'll be nice. Those games will be at home. Like the Brewers will be hosting wild card games. They've earned a good enough seed to do that. It's not like it's 1 or 2 seat or bust. It'll be great that they're at home. But
are you going to playoff games? Have you purchased tickets?
No, I have not, although tickets did come available last week. We talked to Rick Schlesinger about that, the Brewers president of business operations, on the Bill Michaels show. I was thinking about maybe trying to go work a game. The problem is they're during the middle of the day, and, well, you know, Simpson, I'm employed. I have a job. I can't just bust off for a daytime baseball game.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, Grant. You can't take one day off. I mean,
these are next week, aren't they already? Starting like the first, second, third, is that it, Grant?
Well, yeah, it's not even that I could take a day off. It's that I should, Simpson, wouldn't you agree that I should be on air at 4 o'clock? If the Brewers play a playoff game at 1, that I should be on air at 4 to talk about it. Like, that's more important than me going to the game, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you can do your broadcast anywhere, so why wouldn't you just do it from the Brewer parking lot?
But that's so much work. Like, you understand how it is. You got to plug stuff in, and what if something doesn't work?
Next item of business, obviously the Packers looking dominant for periods of time in that game on Sunday against the Titans. Malik Willis, the revenge tour has begun and ended in Tennessee, and I'm assuming Jordan Love's going to play this weekend against the Vikings.
You know what I thought, though? I thought he was going to play yesterday. So he warmed up on Sunday, not yesterday, Sunday. He warmed up on Sunday, looked really good, didn't have a brace on. It was my impression throughout that game and into yesterday that Jordan Love could have played on Sunday, but they elected not to play him. And then Matt LaFleur comes to the podium yesterday, Simpson, and maybe it's good gamesmanship. Was like, I don't know, we'll see. He's going to be limited this week. We obviously want to have him back. That was a serious injury. The gamesmanship from Matt LaFleur has been excellent. I'm not sure what to think anymore.
Well, and you got Sam Darnold with a bruised knee. So he's going to be, questionable, possible, potential, perhaps, probable, whatever you want to call it, for Sunday's game, which is for control of the NFC North.
Yeah, the winner of, and that's why it's exciting. I know we're taking a bus trip on Sunday with Seahawks Carpetland. That should be a game that everyone should want to go see, because the team that wins, right, both teams, if the Packers win, they're going to move to what? I got to do the math in my head. 3-1.
Yeah, and the Vikings will be 3-1.
And the Vikings will also be 3-1. Yeah.
Yeah, and I don't know. The Bears, obviously, not a factor in this equation. Lions, obviously, still, they got to win, but struggling, and they got a Monday night game against an undefeated team. So, yeah, Packers, Vikings, very important
There's
early in the season.
A lot of excitement with this game and a lot riding on it, of course. I mean, you know, we've got coworkers here that are just over the top with their Viking wins recently.
They're unrelenting. And they have zero.
They're insufferable, Gene. And
I know.
They work in a building that includes Simpson. How could?
Oh, you didn't. You weren't here during the Patriots' heyday, Grant. You weren't here during the heyday
when it was.
Take a Vikings fan and multiply that by a million, and that's how bad I was when Brady was winning all them Super Bowls.
Like, and I know not all these people are on the air, but like Tony and Puck's on the air. And Cedric upstairs, like, these people, oh my God.
Yeah. Cedric's not bad. He's learned his place over the years. He loves his Vikings, and that's fine, but he doesn't come down here and walk around like a peacock.
Okay, he doesn't peacock. Okay, well, that's fine. Well, Vikings fans, they are insufferable. Bears fans are depressed, and they should be. Vikings fans, I just, those folks, respectfully.
Big game on Sunday.
They are the worst.
Yeah,
Grant,
yeah.
Before we go, we were talking briefly while we were waiting to go live. We have a vending machine here that is owned by someone that works in the building. It weighs about a bazillion pounds. It took 9 grown men to get that stupid eBay purchased vending machine in the building. I think he wanted to put it upstairs at the time, and we said, no, bro, it's going in the mail room. It's on the first floor. Now the bill changer has been dead and not working for months and months and months on end. It's no longer a temporary thing. It seems permanent, but he's upset because we're not buying Gardettos out of his machine so he can put his kids through, you know, technical school. I am a huge fan of Gardettos. The problem I have with the Gardettos, it's my favorite item in the machine. The problem I have is that it's sort of it's an unknown category when it comes to what you're going to get when you open the bag. I'm a rye chip guy, so sometimes you open up the bag and there's one rye chip. Sometimes there's 10. You know, these are the little snack size bags. So yeah. It's hit or miss with those. What's your go-to snack in the vending machine at your office?
Well, I don't use the vending machine at my office currently. Sometimes I get a Red Bull out of there. If I need a little afternoon I'm a big afternoon caffeine guy. I need coffee. I need Red something Bull? Around 2:15, 2. I need it. So if I don't pack something, that's what I'll get out of the vending machine. I always liked the Gardettos at the vending machine, at your vending machine, because they were only 75 cents. As soon as an item gets over a dollar, my expectations just go up a lot. Like, I expect a certain level of consistency and quality if an item's over a dollar. So if a bag of Gardettos is 75 cents, I still think that's the best item, Simpson. I'm happy to hear that the price hasn't gone up, because God knows the price of everything else has gone up the last couple of years, Simpson, you know?
We know, but not... The Gardettos are still affordable. Gardettos. Yeah, they're still affordable.
I didn't know that was where the Gardettos money was going. I didn't know it was going to someone's college fund. Yes.
Not college, technical school.
Yeah, it's
big difference. It's a little more affordable. Maybe a community college.
I like
college.
It even more. That's practical.
Maybe something that doesn't offer parking to its students. You know, something that isn't as expensive.
Yeah.
I do want to circle back to the puffy vest. We got it.
We're going to get it. Yep. Me and Grant going to get drunk this weekend at Oktoberfest. Bro, I hope you're ready. I hope you're ready, because the moment I see you at Fest, it's on like Donkey Kong.
Oh, man.
You don't even know what's coming. You ever been picked up by another human being?
Another grown man?
I don't think you can pick me up, Simpson. I don't think you have what it takes.
Oh, God. Oh, man. I love a challenge. I love a challenge from these wafy little models that are running around with their dirty mustaches.
Size medium.
Is your wife, girlfriend lady, going to be with you?
No, she's got to work.
All right. I was really hoping I could emasculate you in front of her.
T-shirt, size medium.
I don't think you could. Simpson, I'm not a cocky, you know me, Gene. I'm not an in-your-face man's man. But Simpson, where is this coming from? I don't think you have it in me to do what you're saying that you want to do.
You take me, you add alcohol, you put me in front of a bunch of people on display. It's like King Kong, baby. King Kong. Okay.
Is picking you
it's
up.
It's louder random. And bigger and more disastrous. You know what I'm saying?
The Hulk. It happens. It's a thing.
I suppose. I can see it now. If there's booze and an audience involved, I guess that's all it takes.
Yeah. When are you going to be around? Thursday, Friday, Saturday? You're
going
to hang
going to the game on Saturday, but I got him for Thursday and Friday.
Okay,
so
Thursday and Friday. We'll
I will
you.
Be around Thursday night. That is well, and Friday, but Friday we got broadcast. We'll be at Flipside for, you know, the Golden Can. And
yeah, but
and
you're coming down
stuff,
to the tapping, right?
Yeah, at some point, yeah, because Evo's show will be done, and then I'm probably going to go find Bill, do a good amount of his show. I want to go to the tapping on Friday, yeah.
You're not going to make it if you're going to do Bill's show. Tapping's
at
11.
He's at the ground.
He's at the ground.
Okay, all right. Well, then I got to, if you're going to be in an official capacity, I got to take it easy. All right, Grant Bills. You're no fun at all. You're no fun.
That's not true.
I knew the bride when she used to rock and roll.
Yeah.
All right, Grant, well, have a good show this afternoon. I have no plans to get day drunk. I have a doctor's appointment, so I doubt I'll be calling you, but maybe someday next week.
We'll see you soon. We'll see you this week.
All right, well, I look forward to seeing you both. Happy Oktoberfest week. Yeah. Thanks for the time.
Oh. Prost.
Grant Bills, Wisco Sports Show, weekday afternoons across the state, across
all
the world.
All across the state.
All over the place. Bad News, Happy Music coming up next.
Rock Mornings, only on 95.7 The Rock.
You're about to enter a beautiful, exciting, wonderful new world.
A cockroach living in your nostril.
Now that's just nasty.
Add in some haven't pooped for 30 days.
Poop is raining from the ceilings. Poop.
And sprinkle in some hashtag Florida Man for flavor.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man.
Florida Man quits his Burger King job, steals all of their chicken nuggets.
It's bad news.
Bad news.
With happy music.
Let's rock.
A library.
Where they have books?
In suburban Detroit was forced to close. Why?
Pigs. One, two, four, but no three. I haven't even guessed.
Why? Why was it forced to close?
Killer bees.
Getting closer.
I'm getting closer?
The two animal things are in the realm, and the bees are much closer than the pigs. Royal Oak Public Library in suburban Detroit forced to close over the weekend when they opened up a DVD case from the overnight box drop or book drop, and a bunch of cockroaches came out of it.
Do not like.
Yeah.
Like they were put in there on purpose?
While I don't think that a bunch of cockroaches would get into a DVD case.
For no reason.
For no reason.
Oh, that's icky.
They announced the issue on social media, said the book drops were immediately locked.
Mm-hmm.
All items that were in those book drops bagged up and isolated in our garage.
Mm-hmm.
Made it sound like they had an infestation. Apparently that freaked a bunch of people out. One person said, quote, I just picked up some books this morning, so I wrapped the books from today and put them in the deep freezer.
Mm-hmm.
Several days at 0 degrees will kill nearly all critters. People freezing books. This is COVID again? You're putting your packages from Amazon in a room for 3 days before you open them?
Well.
Library didn't have any other information at first. They just said it appeared to be multiple species of bugs, but we aren't sure. They, of course, called a pest company to come out and take a look. Pest company determined that the bugs were cockroaches and there was no infestation.
They were like pretty much isolated
to the one DVD.
And the book drop.
And that one book drop. The library did reopen yesterday afternoon. No indication that the bugs were placed there intentionally. So apparently it was just a place with an infestation. Or there was some kind of food on it and attracted outside roaches to the book drop and they got in and...
No.
Yeah. Not sure if it was a Bug's Life DVD or what was going on there.
So it was in somebody's house that they think was maybe so infested they crawled in there before they returned.
Or there was food somehow, you know, like let's say you're eating a pizza and you grab the DVD and you put it back and there's cheese or pizza or sauce
but that
on the DVD.
All of a sudden mean cockroaches are everywhere.
Dude, I don't know. A bunch of cockroaches got into a library book drop and they had to shut the library down. It's gross. It's nasty.
Mm-hmm.
Infestation.
Mm-hmm.
Don't
mm-hmm.
want that.
Mm-mm.
Yeah. Not quite sure what the plan here with these two guys is, but. Two men with the very same name teamed up for a crime spree in the UK.
So John Oliver and John Oliver?
Yes, they have the very same name.
Dolomite is my name and f*** up mother f*** my game.
Their names are Dolomite?
No. Their names, or name, is Bernie McDonough. B-E-R-N-I-E. M-C-D-O-N-A-G-H. Bernie McDonough.
Okay.
One is 35, the other one is 56.
My name is Jason Bourne. I live in Paris.
My name is Jason Bourne and I live in Paris. No, your name is Bernie McDonough. And apparently they're from two different towns and not related. But you see the mugshots and you're like, maybe they
like
are
like doppelganger kind of thing?
I wouldn't say they look exactly alike, but you could see some
resemblance.
These two geniuses pulled off a string of heists last month.
Separate though.
No, together. They got together.
They got together and they did it together.
Yeah. Teamed up.
Oh.
Teamed up X-Men style. Yeah. For a string of robberies. Broke into people's houses, stole jewelry, 55-inch TV, security cameras got them on video. So both Bernies were arrested and just got sentenced.
In death, a member of Project Mayhem has a name.
His name is Bernie.
His
Bernie
name
McDonough.
Is Robert Paulson.
Not Robert Paulson.
His name is Robert Paulson.
No, it's Bernie not. McDonough.
His name is Robert Paulson.
No,
no,
it's not.
His name is Bernie McDonough. So is the other guy. They're both named Bernie McDonough. I don't know, like...
Did they change? One of them changed their name so they could be the same?
No, I think they're legitimately, legally named Bernie McDonough. And they just somehow found each other and said, hey, let's go on a crime spree. The younger one, 35-year-old Bernie McDonough, got 2 years in prison, has to pay a fine. The older Bernie had some DNA that was traced back to a separate burglary last year, so he got just under 5 years. For the current crime spree plus some stuff he did a couple years ago.
My name is Inigo Montoya. You killed my father. Prepare to die.
No. Bernie.
Name's actually Bernie McDonough. Been here for a while. Been doing crimes for a long time.
The name is Dalton.
Oh. Name's not Dalton. It's Bernie. Bernie McDonough. So is this guy. My brother Daryl. My other brother Daryl.
That's what I was thinking of immediately.
Yeah. These two guys teaming up. I don't know if they found each other on Facebook.
They had to, maybe it was like a Bernie Fest or
Gathering of the Kyles.
Yes, yeah, the Gathering of the Bernies, exactly.
Yeah, I don't know. But Bernie McDonough and Bernie McDonough got together and committed a bunch of crimes and they both got caught.
Well, what's the name?
White trash name, yes.
Mandy.
Nope.
Marilyn.
Nope.
Brittany.
Nope.
Tiffany.
Nope.
Candace.
Nope.
Don't f*** with me on this. I know this.
Do you see me f***ing with you?
All right, speed round. I'm going to rattle off some names, and when I hit it, buzz it, okay?
I will tell you.
You got me?
Yeah.
All right, Brandy, Heather, Channing, Brianna, Amber, Sabrina, Melody, Dakota, Sierra, Bambi, Crystal, Samantha, Autumn, Ruby, Taylor, Tara, Tammy, Lauren, Charlene, Chantel, Courtney, Misty, Jenny, Krista, Mindy, Noelle, Shelby, Trina, Reba, Cassandra, Nikki, Kelsey, Shauna, Jolene, Erlene, Claudine, Savannah, Casey, Dolly, Kendra, Kali, Chloe, Devin, Emily, Becky?
Nope.
Wait, was it any one of those names with a Lynn after it?
Yes.
Oh, I got you, mother. I got you. Okay. Brandy Lynn, Heavenland,
Tammy Lynn.
Not Bernie Lynn, just Bernie McDonough and his buddy Bernie McDonough going out committing crimes. Same name. I can't imagine that. Like, wait a minute, what's your birthday? Mm-hmm. What's your favorite color? Mm-hmm. I mean, do they have anything else that...
They had to have met at some sort of festival or a gathering or something.
Or maybe some sort of one of them got confused for the other guy, right? Yeah. Oh, is this Bernie? No, I'm calling Bernie's phone. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am Bernie.
Mm-hmm.
Well, wait a minute. Which Bernie are you? Very strange. Or the name Bernie McDonough is just very common
in
the area where they live in the UK.
Oh, here's another one. Bernie McDonough.
Are you ready for this one?
I don't know.
Last but not least.
Doubt it.
Have you ever had something in your body explode?
I had an ovarian cyst rupture.
Okay.
So sorta.
Sorta. Appendix.
It was painful.
Spleen.
No, nothing like that. No. Kidney stone. No, none of that.
About a muscle. You ever had a muscle explode?
No.
You've had Charlie horses.
Yes.
They ripped a muscle off. A tendon off your bone or something like that?
No.
25-year-old woman in South Carolina named Jessica Johnson.
Like, not her Achilles tendon, but a muscle?
Decided to do a CrossFit circuit last month called the Murph Challenge. Probably heard this one, right? The Murph Challenge. When you really like working out. I mean, like... You run a mile, you do 300 squats, 200 push-ups, 100 pull-ups, and then you run another mile. They call it the Murph Challenge.
Okay.
I think that's what happened to those lacrosse players at Tufts University.
I think so, too. So she does that, and then...
Let me reiterate. You run a mile, you do 300 squats, 200 push-ups, 100 pull-ups, then another mile.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, she did not just pick up her Lululemons and... start from zero. She's been working out for a while. In great shape.
Of course.
Works out all the time.
That. Yeah, you can do that without...
But hadn't done a serious upper body workout in a while. And because she went so hard and had so much gusto behind her, her bicep basically exploded. Exploded. Her arms were sore and swollen the next day. Couldn't straighten them out. Her friends were calling her the Hulk because her bicep had gotten so big.
That's not normal.
Finally decided to go to the urgent care a couple days later.
Couple days?
When she finally lost feeling in her hands. So the bicep is sore, swollen. Your friends are calling you the Hulk. You don't go anywhere. You don't do anything. But 3 days later, when you lose feeling in your hands, you decide to go to the ER. They sent her right away from urgent care to the ER because her crazy workout had caused something called rhabdo. We talked about this earlier.
This is the same thing?
Yeah. Rhabdo, whatever it is.
Something, just go with rhabdo.
It's when your muscle fibers are so damaged, the cells die and the toxins get into your blood. It can cause liver damage, kidney damage, even kill you. Early symptom is dark urine, which she had. She thought she was just really dehydrated. Apparently, Jessica will be okay, however.
The next day when I woke up, I was really, really sore and my arms were swollen. And I thought that I was just super sore because I haven't done upper body in a while. And I especially haven't done pull-ups in a while. Like, it's been a couple years. My issue was my arms. They were so swollen, I couldn't straighten out my arms all week. And my hands and fingers were starting to go numb on Friday and tingling. So that's why Saturday morning I went to urgent care and they immediately just sent me to the ER.
Yeah.
A little giggle there, but it's not like they just gave her some meds. They had to cut her arms open to relieve the pressure and the swelling so they could save her kidneys from the rhabdo, exploding bicep.
Well, that's icky.
Doctors told her to ease back into exercise for a while. Sounds like she'll be taking that advice. She's also saying she's done with the extreme workouts for now.
Yeah, those arms are...
She said her new routine is running, walking, and some, quote, gentle Pilates.
Yes.
Not so much with the Murph challenge.
Don't need that.
Exploding biceps. I don't think you can get those from sitting on the couch watching Netflix, can you?
Grab that remote too aggressively, maybe.
Yes. Bad news, happy music. On Rock Mornings with Brian and Gene, we'll get to our daily check-ins after Soundgarden.
Rock Mornings, Monday to Friday, 6 to 9. Call.
Hello.
Email.
I tried emailing you.
Text. So many ways to check in with us. Check. We rely on you guys for traffic updates, requests, and all sorts of other stuff.
Check this out.
RockMornings.com is the website with all our contact info if you want to get in touch with us. Let's see what we got. Davey, earlier we were talking about the book from 1926.
Oh, yeah. How to Raise a Baby. Baby, basically.
Yeah. 100-year-old advice on how to raise a baby. Talking about giving it cod oil. Davey said, we used to give my oldest cod liver oil with orange juice when and it was awful. But I will tell you, as he got older, there isn't anything he won't eat. The least picky kid I've ever met in my life when it comes to food. Any sort of food was delicious instead of cod liver oil.
I'm not sure that those two things equate, but...
Yeah, like he had so much bad cod liver oil that he said anything is better than this.
And then he became a non-picky eater. I don't know if that's it. I think the correlation might not exist.
I can see where you would make that assumption. Let's see. Vicky and Blair wanted to hear Beat You There by Will Dempsey. I went and tried to, I'd never heard of it, so I went to YouTube and it's not good and not a song we play. So sorry, Vicky. But you can find it on YouTube if you really need to hear it.
Well, and thanks for expanding your musical
I don't know if she knows
knowledge.
What radio station we are. I don't know if Vicky, I don't know. It's not even close. It's not even close, bro. Like, if we played that, people would be like, what the hell's going on with that station? Uh-huh. You know what I mean? Talking about that house in Connecticut. What was it? 215 Uncas Point Road.
$35 million.
Yeah. 6 bedrooms, 5 baths. They got their own vineyard, their own orchard, their own Stonehenge. But they got 4 docks, and they're in a bay.
Well, they had a guest house and a carriage house and... Yeah. You know,
Stonehenge.
Exercise room, outdoor kitchen, pool.
And they have perhaps one of the most uninspired go-kart tracks of all time.
They do have a go-kart track,
yeah, and
which
it looks,
is nice.
It's big, too. It's not just like a circle, like a lap. It's got.
But it really is not.
Nothing. There's
exciting.
No life to that thing.
There's no design elements.
Tom said they need to build a Mario Kart track. Also said the go-kart track in the movie Heavyweights was better. Yeah, I think pretty much any go-kart track is better than the one they had out there. Especially for a $35 million home. Apparently, Smokin' Joe and his girlfriend are just laying there naked texting us from Wyoming. I don't know what
that
the hell they're
more
doing.
More information than I needed, Brian.
Well, I don't know, man. They're both texting us at the same time. I have no idea what these two chuckleheads are doing. Smokin' Joe.
He He's got said, cattle to take care of.
Said, good morning. I just turned a lady friend onto your morning show, so be nice. I asked him if he had gotten a new girlfriend. He said, yes, I do, and this one is not crazy.
That's good. That's
well,
starting,
several minutes starting. Later.
Uh-oh. The crazy started?
I'm smoking Joe's girlfriend. He is smoking all right, and I'm not crazy. You know who's not crazy? People who don't have to tell you they're not crazy.
Now, don't be judgy.
She said, I'm just crazy about smoking Joe.
Aww. That's good. That's nice.
It's good
that's
found each other and that they're staying in Wyoming, I got to say. You know what I mean? Big state, plenty of room.
Spread
right?
It. They can spread
not
out.
Not near us. Spread out.
I'll quit. He's good.
I'm Victoria Cash, and I want to invite you to a place called Lucky Land, where you can play over 100 social casino-style games for free for your chance to redeem some serious prizes. So what are you waiting for? The best way to discover your luck is to spin. So go to LuckyLandSlots.com. That's LuckyLandSlots.com. And get lucky today. At Lucky Land. No purchase necessary. VGW Group. Void where prohibited by law. 18 plus. Terms and conditions apply.